Welcome back to Developer's Introduction to Data Science. So now let's learn more about how you can pick the best model for your data science scenario with automated machine learning. Understanding the predictive power of a set of features with respect to a dependent variable is a very tricky problem, and there is no universal metric which can tell you how to do that. So the answer to the question, which algorithm should I use, is always it depends. It depends on the size, the quality, and the nature of your data. It depends on what you want to do with that specific answer. Finally, the answer to the question, which parameters I should use, is also very challenging. As you know, hyperparameters are higher level parameters that cannot be learned directly from the data using gradient descent or other optimization algorithms. They describe the structural information about a model that must be decided before fitting model parameters. Manual parameter setting and searching for optimal parameters values based on learning and experience can be also very time-consuming. Different estimators are better suited for different types of data and also different problems. So often I would say that the hardest part of solving a machine learning problem can be finding the right estimator for your job. That's why I very often use automated machine learning, which is the process of automating the time-consuming and iterative task of machine learning model development. Automated machine learning takes uncertainty into account, incorporating a probabilistic model to determine the best pipeline to try next. This approach allows automated machine learning to explore the most promising possibilities without wasting time. So now let's have a closer look at the different automated machine learning capabilities. First of all, with automated machine learning, you need to identify the machine learning problem that you want to solve. This can be classification, forecasting, or regression. Then you have to specify the source and the format of the labeled training data. This can be NumPy arrays or a pandas data frame. Finally, you need to configure the computer target for model training, such as your local computer, Azure Machine Learning computes, remote VMs, or Azure Databricks, for example. And during training, the Azure Machine Learning service creates a number of in parallel pipelines that try different algorithms and parameters. It will stop only once it hits the exit criteria that you define in the experiment. The AutoML config class represents a configuration for submitting an automated machine learning experiment in Azure Machine Learning. This configuration object contains and persists the parameters for configuring the experiment run, as well as the training data that needs to be used at the runtime. To learn more, please see aka.ms/AutoML config class.